We go through real quick a couple of different ways you can analyze steady state activity data in order to get Michaelis-Menten parameters. So let's say we have this data set down here where we have varying substrate concentrations in units of micromolar, and then we have different initial velocities, V, that are in units of micromolar per second. So this might be micromolar of product produced per second or micromolar of substrate consumed per second. Okay. The preferred method, and we go through two different methods. The first is a nonlinear regression. This is preferred. So you can use a software such as Origin, which is available through UCF apps, and you can plug in the data. And what's really nice is there's no transformation necessary of the data at all. You use the data as it is in terms of the substrate concentrations and the velocities. And all you do is you take the data where substrate concentration, of course, is on the x-axis, and the velocity, the initial velocities, are on the y-axis. And so you can fit the data by going to first plotting the data. And we're going to plot this as a scatter plot. Might take a little bit. Let's try again. There we go. Okay. And we see that the data show what you would expect for a steady state activity plot. We have saturation activity. Okay. And this looks basically like it has the hyperbolic shape that we expect for this. Okay. So our substrate concentrations are on the x-axis and initial velocities are on the y-axis. So if you click on any of the data points, you'll see that all the data points highlight like this. Okay. And then what we're going to do is we're going to fit the data by going to Analysis, Fitting, and then we're going to do a nonlinear curve fit. Okay. So this is going to give us several options to do a nonlinear regression on the data. So wait for this to open, and it will give us a bunch of options. So here's the nonlinear regression fit window. We're going to go to category, and then for this, we can do a hyperbola. So remember, these are hyperbolic models, or I think we can use enzyme kinetics. And yeah, you can go to Enzyme Kinetics, Michaelis-Menten. Okay, and if you go to formula, you'll see that it already has plugged in for the formula for the fit as y equals Vmax times x over Km plus x. Okay, so x is the substrate concentration, y is the initial velocities, and so what this is going to do is it's going to fit the data and it's going to return the parameters Vmax and Km. So it's going to use the substrate data that's in our plot and the velocity data and return these Michaelis-Menten parameters. So all we have to do is hit fit. All right. And so this is initial fit. So you can see that it doesn't fit very well. The program's going to calculate it. We're going to hit no here. And it's going to return a fit line, which is shown here in red. And if this fits well, then this should go through the center of all the points in the same way you would expect, say, for a linear regression that you might do just on an Excel or on a calculator. Okay, so it's going to report the parameters. So we have the plots, and it gives us the Vmax of 15 micromolar per second. Plus a statistical error that has to do with the fitting of the plot, and then a Km of 240 micromolar. That's exactly what we should expect for this. Okay, so this is the most preferred method, and that has to do with, we're not going to get into too much about why that is, but it has to do with essentially the errors you might get from real life data that could influence how these curve sort of fit. So the nonlinear regression is a much more preferred way of doing this than what we're going to try in the second series. Okay, so but sometimes, and particularly at the when enzymology was first come up and there was not programs that could do nonlinear regression, linearization was of the equation followed by linear regression was a much easier way to do this. And this could be done without, remember, this can be done without even very powerful computers, much less ones that have software for nonlinear regression. So a lot of the literature or the traditional literature uses this linearization method, such as using a Lineweaver-Burk plot, which we're going to use now, where they linearize the Michaelis-Menten equation to this. If you haven't seen this, then please check out the video on the YouTube channel that goes over this linearization, how to linearize this. But this is basically just an algebraic rearrangement of the Michaelis-Menten equation. Okay, so to use this, what we're going to do is we have to first transform the data. So again, if you look at the video, you'll know that the 1 over velocity is going to be your y-axis, and 1 over the substrate concentration is going to be your x-axis. So we have the data here in Excel, so this can easily be done in Excel. And so we have to transform the data first, so we're going to make 2 columns over velocity. Okay, and then the units will be 1 over micromolar. This will be seconds per micromolar. Right. Okay. So we won't use the 0, 0 point because 1 over 0 is going to give us an error. So we'll go to the next one. So 1 over E5. Then we can click and drag down and over. Okay. So now we have all of our, we have our data transformed as 1 over S0 and 1 over V. We can take this, these data, and plot them. And so you'll notice that instead of having a hyperbolic plot that we would see if we just plotted V versus S, we have a linearized, the data show up as a line or look like they could be, you could reasonably believe that's a linear plot. And that makes sense given that we're using the linearized equation. Okay. So on here, we just do add trend line. And you're going to get an R squared in order to display the equation of the chart. And of course, since these are generated data, the R squared is beautiful. It's 1. And then we get our slope. And then we get our intercept. Okay. And remember, slope relates. If you go back and look at the video, the slope will help you determine the KM value while the intercept will help you determine the Vmax value. So you can use these values in order to back calculate the Vmax and the KM, and they should match exactly what we got for the nonlinear regression with a KM of 240 micromolar and a Vmax of 15 micromolar per second.